Everyone in Microsoft is responsible for protecting data. First and foremost, make sure you understand the risks and what it is you're trying to mitigate.
Hi, everyone. My name is Jamila Rowland, and I'm reporting from Microsoft Digital, the organization that powers, protects, and transforms the company. I'm here with Carmichael Patton, a security architect in Microsoft Digital Security and Resiliency, our internal security team. We're here to talk about how we're deploying our Zero Trust security model across the company, the value of network segmentation, and strategies for supporting identity and device health. Hi, Carmichael. So can you give us a high-level overview of our Zero Trust security model and how we're using it here at Microsoft?
Microsoft's approach to Zero Trust means we don't assume any identity or device is secure. We continuously verify that, which allows us to reduce the risk in our environment by verifying those identities and validating the device compliance before granting the access. So first verifying the health of your identity, then verifying the health of your device. And then the full range of all of that is all the telemetry that we also get from the devices and from your identity is mentioned, you know, making sure that we continuously monitor those connections and then reassess or reevaluate the health every periodic time.
Nice. Yeah, we need to make sure that everyone is secure from all angles. And I know my work computer has policies to manage this, but what about using my personal device for work, like my phone? As I understand it, our employees are using their personal devices for work more and more. How has your team handled that?
We adopted a strong bring your own device policy, or BYOD policy, years ago. And as a result of that, we had to find challenging ways of actually making sure that people enroll their devices and become managed. Of course, issue everybody a laptop too. So they always have access on a work-related device, but a lot of folks want to be able to be mobile or have that ability to connect back when they want to.
Yeah, I do appreciate being able to check my email when I'm out running errands. It's nice to know when something pops off that I need to jump in on. I also want to talk about segmentation. What makes it a core part of our security strategy at Microsoft?
And a lot of what we do with our architecture is actually accessing things through the internet itself. About 93% of our traffic is all cloud-based. You still have devices in your network, like IoT devices, printers, Polycom phones, you know, your different devices that are kind of around the hallways and things like that, right? Those are all connected. So a good segmentation strategy, you want to try to pull as many of those things into their own segments.
Yeah, that makes sense. That way, if there's one vulnerability, say someone clicks on a phishing email, mom, it doesn't compromise the entire system. Not that I've ever done that before. To that point, how do you make sure employees like me don't share things we shouldn't?
So everyone at Microsoft is responsible for protecting data, whether that's from ensuring that your classification on the document or the SharePoint site is classified and protected in the right ways. We use features like Microsoft Information Protection and the sensitivity button in Microsoft 365 applications. We use Azure Information Protection in some areas as well. Cloud App Security, which can monitor those connections of where the documents are being transited and places like that.
Yeah, the last thing you want is to accidentally send something highly confidential to your mom, who still gets phished. And speaking of cloud security, many customers still use the on-premise version of Active Directory. Can you share what we're using now that we've moved to the cloud? And for those still using it, can on-premise Active Directory alone work to implement Zero Trust, say if we install Microsoft Monitoring Agent?
Azure Active Directory is the platform that we use internally here to support our conditional access, which gives you that health attestation. With the Microsoft Monitoring Agent, you do get a good amount of telemetry out of that, which is awesome, but you're still missing out on that automated device enforcement. So you won't be able to necessarily use conditional access policies, device-based policies to allow access. So our recommendation is to create an AAD instance as a replica to your on-prem AD, do the Azure AD Connect so that you're connecting your on-prem identities to the cloud identities.
And what's our process for giving guests access to the resources they need?
When allowing guests to connect to our resources or view documents, we use the least privileged access model with guest MFA and tenant alignment process. We can apply the controls to require MFA on those guest accounts. So they register in our tenant as a guest with their own account, and then we can do some enforcement there.
Yeah, that makes sense. That way you're able to monitor as needed and no one gets access to more than they need. So if a customer is on a journey to adopt Zero Trust, where should they start?
You know, Microsoft wasn't born in the cloud either, so we're on this journey too. Yeah, I think the most critical piece of advice I would give is start simple, but first and foremost, understand what your environment is, the telemetry, to make sure you understand the risks and what it is you're trying to mitigate.
Hey, that's some good advice. Create a strong foundation to build on, and don't be afraid to ask for help when you need it. Well, thank you so much, Carmichael, for chatting with me. And for everyone who joined us, we have tons of resources for you. You can learn more about Microsoft's Zero Trust Security Model at aka.ms/insidetrack.